Warhorse author Michael Moore-Purgos giving Ricky some top tips on how to enjoy life to the fullest post-lockdown.
Firstly, it's a real privilege to be able to speak to you, so thank you for giving us your time. Michael, can I ask, how have you found the last year?
I think sad, because living through a time of great uncertainty and an awareness, really, that the suffering that this is causing, not just here in our country, but all over the world. There are positives, however, it's not all been good. What we've learned, I think, is to look after each other, care for each other. I think we've learned more to take nothing for granted.
But you talk about some of the good things that we've managed to get out of the pandemic. Can you tell us about your new book and the inspiration behind it?
One morning last March, this blackbird started singing in the tree just above, and it just went on and on. I thought, well, sing back. So I whistled back, and the blackbird sang back, imitating what I'd whistled. And we went on having this conversation. It really felt like a conversation between blackbird and person. I was enchanted by that. Next day, I got out of bed, and this bird started singing again. Same one, same tree. And I really thought, this bird is talking to me. It's saying something about sharing this world that we live in. And I wrote this story called A Song of Gladness, which is essentially about a blackbird singing his song, which can go all around the world, and it will chase away sadness.
What would your message be to those children listening to this?
My advice to you, if I can give it to you, is to go out there and explore. It's a wonderful world, and you enjoy it, because we're meeting our friends again, meeting our teachers again, going back to school again. And what do you do now? You enjoy it, which means that you work as hard as you can, play as hard as you can, have fun. What I'd really love you to do is to read lots of books.
Brilliant. Well, Michael, thank you so much for talking to NewsRound.
Thank you so much. Bye-bye.